Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this video, we are going to write the expression of the average acceleration vector. Determine the instantaneous acceleration vector. Calculate the magnitude of the instantaneous acceleration vector. Specify whether the motion of a particle is accelerated, decelerated, or uniform. Solve an exercise about the acceleration vector.
Consider a car moving on a straight path. Now we repeat the animation in slow motion. Observe. The magnitude of the velocity vector changes with time. Now, let's move to another animation. Consider a particle moving on a circular path. Now we repeat the animation in slow motion. The velocity vector has a constant magnitude, but the direction of the velocity changes with time. The acceleration is the time rate of a change of the velocity. Acceleration occurs when either the magnitude or direction of the velocity or both are changed.
In the previous video, we defined the average velocity vector, which is the change in the position vector over the change in time. And now, we are going to define the average acceleration vector, which is the change in the velocity over the change in time. So A average equals delta V over delta T, which is equal to V2 minus V1 over T2 minus T1, where V2 and V1 are the velocities of the object at time T2 and T1 respectively. Since delta T is a scalar and positive quantity, then A average and delta V found in the same direction.
Let's move to the instantaneous acceleration vector. To determine the expression of this vector, we need to do just like we did with the instantaneous velocity vector in the previous video. So we define the instantaneous acceleration vector, or simply the acceleration vector, as being the limit as delta t goes to zero of delta v over delta t. Mathematically, this is the derivative of the velocity vector with respect to time. Therefore, the acceleration is the time derivative of the velocity vector. In the Cartesian system, the velocity vector is of the form vxi plus vyj. Therefore, to obtain the expression of the acceleration, we need to differentiate the x and the y components of the velocity. The acceleration is equal to v prime, which is equal to vx prime I plus vy prime j. The x prime is the x component of the acceleration, and vy prime is the y component. Now, consider a particle moving on a curved path. Observe the acceleration of the particle during its motion. And now, observe the x and the y components of the acceleration. Finally, we want to determine the magnitude of the acceleration vector. Its magnitude is equal to the square root of the x component squared plus the y component squared.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, let's take an application about the acceleration vector. Consider a particle m moving in the xy plane. Its position vector is given by 3t squared minus 4i plus t cubed plus t plus 2j in SI units. This animation shows the trajectory of m during the first 6 seconds. Determine the acceleration vector and its magnitude at time 1 second. Given that if x equals a, where a is a constant, then the time derivative of x equals 0. And if x equals at to the power n, where a and n are two constants, then the time derivative of x equals nat to the power n minus 1. To determine the acceleration vector, we have to determine the velocity vector. And the velocity vector is given by the time derivative of the position vector. Now, let's differentiate the position vector with respect to time. The derivative of 3t squared minus 4 equals 6t plus 0. And the derivative of t cubed plus t plus 2 equals 3t squared plus 1 plus 0. So, v equals 6ti plus 3t squared plus 1j in SI units. Now, a is given by the time derivative of the velocity vector. So let's differentiate the velocity vector with respect to time. The derivative of 6t equals 6, and the derivative of 3t squared plus 1 equals 6t plus 0. So a equals 6i plus 6tj in SI units. To determine the acceleration vector at time 1 second, just replace t by 1 second. So a of 1 equals 6i plus 6j in meter per second squared. Now let's determine the magnitude of the acceleration at time 1 second. A of 1 equals the square root of ax squared plus ay squared. Ax equals 6 meters per second squared, and ay also equals 6 meters per second squared. Therefore, A of 1 equals 8.5 meters per second squared.
In many questions, we need to determine the nature of the motion, which means that we want to know if the motion is accelerated or decelerated or uniform. For this, consider a particle m moving along a certain path during a time interval delta t. If the dot product of the acceleration vector and the velocity vector is positive during this time interval, which means that the angle between A and V is acute, then the motion during this time interval is accelerated. If the dot product of the acceleration and the velocity is negative, which means that the angle between A and V is obtuse, then the motion during this time interval is decelerated. Finally, if the dot product of A and V is zero, which means that the acceleration is perpendicular to the velocity, as you see in the last figure, the motion during this time interval is uniform.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.